الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So basically, inshallah, we're going to study this morning. We're going to study two principles of aqidah. And these two principles of aqidah, they have to do with the Quran. Since this is a class that we always have about the Quran, so we're going to connect the dots, as they say. So the first principle, or the first fundamental principle of al-aqidah, that al-Imam Abd al-Rahman ibn Abi Hatim al-Razi rahimahullah mentioned in his risala, in his treatise, which he has taken from his father, Abu Hatim al-Razi, and his uncle, Abu Zur' al-Razi. And they have taken that aqidah from other scholars that they have taken from knowledge. So this is the aqidah of the Salaf al-Salih, aqidah of the righteous predecessors, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his companions, those who came after them. So this principle talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a specific attribute. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the most beautiful names and has the loftiest attributes that befits His Majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from those specific attributes, listiwa, that Allah rose over the throne in a way that befits His Majesty. So the author rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned that the people of the sunnah and the jama'ah, the main body of the Muslim, they believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose over the throne in a way that befits His Majesty. بَائِنٌ مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. And I want you to pay attention to this statement. بَائِنٌ مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. That He is distinct from His creation. So what do you understand from this? He is distinct from His creation. Do you understand anything? What does it mean? In terms of al-aqidah, what is the effect of the word distinct? Abdul Rahman? No. See, that's why explanation has to be there. Distinct from His creation means He's separate from His creation. He's not mixed with His creation. So we have to understand this. This is number one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it does not befit His Majesty to be inside His creation. Okay? So those who say Allah is everywhere, this is the most dangerous statement that a person can make. Why? Because when you say Allah is everywhere, then what do you mean by He's everywhere? If when you say He's everywhere, it means that in any place, even the dirty places, that does not befit His Majesty to be in. Like restrooms and other than that, no. Humans, inside the animals, أعوذ بالله من ذلك. لا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not mixed with His creation. That's why the author said, بَائِنٌ عَنْ خَلْقِهِ. He is distinct from His creation. He's not inside His creation. And those that believe He's inside His creation, those are the Sufis, the extreme Sufiyah. And Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentioned in his book, Madarij al-Salikin, he mentioned there were two Sufis, they were walking. You see how this aqidah, this corrupt aqidah is instilled in some of them. And they heard a sheep say, ma'a, like this, right? He said, labbayka, labbayka, a'udhu billah min dalik. He said, labbayka, labbayka. Oh Allah, I'm here to serve you. Because he believes, wal'iyadu billah, it's like Allah is calling him, wal'iyadu billah. Na'udhu billah min dalik. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's very dangerous. And Abu Mansur al-Hallaj, who was killed because of his heresy and kufr, he said, ana huwa wa huwa ana. That's what he said. He said, I am him and he is me. A'udhu billah. So he believes that him and Allah, They are one entity, وَالْعِيَدُ بِاللَّهِ. May Allah protect us from that. And it's kufr. Someone believes that Allah is him and he is Allah. This is kufr. So this man, he was killed because of this. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it does not befit his majesty to be inside his creation. And there are many, you know, you find it in the books of the Sufis that they وَالْعِيَدُ بِاللَّهِ, they believe in these things. But Ahl Sunnah, alhamdulillah, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose over the throne in a way that befits his majesty. There is another deviant sect beside the Sufis. Those are the ones that they distort the meaning. They distort the meaning. So they say it doesn't mean he rose over the throne. It means he dominated the throne, dominated and conquered. Okay, when you say conquered, you know what you're saying when you say conquered? This is very dangerous, because when you say he conquered the throne, this necessitates that he had to overpower another deity to conquer his throne, and it does not befit his majesty. So the correct way is to affirm to Allah what he affirmed to himself in the Quran. If Allah said, Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arshi istawa, the most gracious, rose over the throne, we affirm to Allah what he affirmed to himself without negating that attribute, without delving into the reality of the attribute because we have no knowledge, and without likening Allah to his creation. This is very important for us to understand. Tayyib. The second principle he mentioned is al-ru'ya, that the believers, they will see their Lord on Yawm al-Qiyamah, on the Day of the Judgment. طيب. What is the proof and evidence from the Quran? Can anybody give me an ayah from the Quran? Faddal. إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا أَحْسَنْتُ. Surah al-Qiyamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وجوه يومئذ نادرة. ضاد. نادرة بالضاد. نادرة means radiant. So faces on that day, means on يوم القيامة, some faces on that day will be radiant, will be shining, will be radiant. إلى ربها نادرة. ضا. Looking at their Lord. نادرة means looking. So they will be looking at their Lord. So the faces will be radiant, and they will be looking at their Lord. May Allah make us from them. Amen. Subhanallah. Al-Kuffar, they will be deprived of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because to see Allah is na'im. Is a pleasure and joy and bliss. And it's something the Shaykh mentioned. He said they will forget all the na'im that Allah has given them after they see their Lord. Allahu Akbar. They will forget everything else. Allahu Akbar. There is no na'im better than looking at the Lord, subhanahu, at his glorious face, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the Lord that you used to worship and you've never seen him. And you get to see him. Allahu Akbar. And that's why Allah said, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ, those who believe in the unseen. And Allah is from the unseen. The angels are from the unseen. Al-Jannah is from the unseen. Hellfire is from the unseen. So you believe, even though you haven't seen it. This is Iman. This is what Iman is. Al-Iman is not when you come on Yawm al-Qiyamah and say, no, I believe. No, it's too late now. It's too late. Al-Kuffar, they will believe on Yawm al-Qiyamah. It will be too late. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them, hey, when he says to them, أَلَيْسَ هَذَا بِالْحَقِّ قَالُوا بَلَا وَرَبِّنَا. Yeah. He would say to them, isn't this the truth? They say, by our Lord, it is the truth. And then he would say to them, فَدُوقُ الْعَذَابِ, taste the punishment. لِيَدُ بِاللَّهِ. Going back to the topic, so وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. Faces on that day, they will be radiant looking at their Lord. Allahu Akbar. And also in Surah Yunus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, للذين أحسنوا الحسنى وزيادة. للذين أحسنوا الحسنى وزيادة. For those who do good, they will have الحسنى. العلماء, they say, علماء التفسير, they say الحسنى is paradise. They will have paradise. وزيادة, and much more. وزيادة means much more. So they said, وزيادة, much more, means looking at their Lord, الله أكبر. So they will get الجنة, and they will get something much more than that, which is looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Now, the people of deviation, those who oppose the الكتاب والسنة, the first categories are the Sufiya. Sheikh mentioned, he said they believe that Allah can be seen in this world and of course in the hereafter. In the hereafter, everyone agrees with them. But in this world, can you see Allah in this world? No, it's impossible. No one can see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If that was the case, Musa would have seen him. Because Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he wanted to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah told him, لن تراني, you will not be able to see me. لن تراني. Means in this world, you will not be able to see me in this world. And Musa, you know what happened to him? He fainted. He fainted. When Allah pointed to the mountain crumbled to dust. And then Musa fainted. Right?
Yeah,
now. Yes.
The mountain,
yes. Like they will not be able
to sustain.
No, they will not be able to sustain. And that's why the Sheikh, Jazakallah khair, that's why the Sheikh said, our bodies in this world, they're weak. On Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us that special power to sustain that. You see? Like here, for example, if you don't go to sleep, you don't eat, what's going to happen? You're going to die. Right? Okay. In Jannah, do you sleep? You don't sleep. There's no sleep in Jannah. And there is no night and day, by the way. There's no night and day in Jannah. It's light, all the time light. There's no night and day. In Jannah, you don't use the bathroom like you do here. It's a deficiency, right? But there, you don't. Because you sweat it out, musk. Subhanallah. Comes out of you, musk. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us that power to sustain seeing him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now, it's impossible for someone to see Allah in this world. Even though the Sufiya, they claim that they can see Allah. They even claim also they see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a wakeful state. This is impossible. How can you see the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a wakeful state? One of the Sufiya, he used to be actually the Mufti of Egypt. I forgot his name. Ali Jama'a, I think. Ali Jama'a, yes. He said, I listened to him, I was like, what is wrong with this man? Is this man okay? He said he read 50 books of the Seerah of the Messenger of Allah. And then after he finished, he saw the Messenger of Allah in a wakeful state. This is ajeeb. How can you see? You saw devil, you don't see the Messenger of Allah. That's not the Messenger of Allah. You can see him in a vision, yes. In a vision, yes, it's true. You see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the vision. Because he said, مَنْ رَآنِي فِي الْمَنَامِ فَقَدْ رَآنِي حَقَّى فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَا يَتَمَتَّلُ بِي. Whoever saw me in a vision, then he has seen me in the truth. Because the shaitan cannot take my shape. Cannot take my shape. And I have seen him. Alhamdulillah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I have seen him. As he is described in the hadith. So, فَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. So this is from the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have seen the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As he is described in the hadith. One time I saw him. When I used to be in Georgia. And the masjid I used to be at, I saw him, in the vision, it was Friday. And I went to the minbar, And I started, إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ like this. And the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was sitting, listening. So that was one time I saw him. I saw him other times. But it's true. You can see the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as he is described in the hadith of the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The most beautiful man you've ever seen. His face is shining. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. No. No, nothing. I was just asking Allah to see him. I was making dua. I didn't do anything special. Just making dua and I saw him. Saw him. One time I saw him. I was with him. And we started ascending into the heaven together. Yeah. All the way until we reached the end of the heaven. I was another time, and there was one time I saw him, and I was sitting in front of him. He was like on the minbar, and he recited to me Surah Al-Fath. I heard his voice. Yeah, he recited Surah Al-Fath, the beginning of Surah Al-Fath to me. I was sitting in front of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his face was shining. And that experience, I can tell you that as Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, he said, as if the sun runs it through his face. This is very true. His face is shining, subhanallah. And when I woke up, it's like I was in a dark tunnel. And the sun hit me in the face, like that. Yeah, still remember that. And there are other, hundreds of ru'ya, alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those that will join. One time, it was me and another brother. And we were in Jannah. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came and he said to us, didn't I tell you that I long to be with my brothers? Like that. It was very, very beautiful, subhanallah. And we long to be with him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But it is easier said than done. You have to follow him. You have to follow his footsteps, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and you comply with the commandment of Allah and his messenger, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Because loving him without following him is a false claim. It's a false love. Love has to be coupled with following him. Yeah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be seen on Yawm al-Qiyamah by the believers. And the people of bid'ah, the people of innovation, they say Allah cannot be seen on Yawm al-Qiyamah. So they use the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا تدركه الأبصار. Sight cannot, visions cannot encompass him. And if you pay attention to this, he did not say, لا تراه الأبصار. He didn't say, vision cannot see him. Or he said, vision cannot encompass him. And there's a big difference between seeing him and encompassing him. So Allah will be seen, but he will not be encompassed. For example, someone says, I've seen the ocean. Has he seen everything in the ocean? No, seen part of the ocean. Right? But he did not encompass the ocean. You see? Someone says, I've seen the sun. He did not see anything, everything in the sun. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' al-amal salih. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.